Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will explain how to customize the default editor window of the Vue Scheduler. I hope everyone is familiar with the default editor window that opens when you double-click the scheduler cells or events. This editor window is used for both adding and editing appointments. First, let me open an existing Vue application where I have added the Vue Scheduler with simple appointments. If you want to know how to create a Vue scheduler and add appointments to it, I have linked the Getting Started video in the above YouTube card. Now, let me run this application using the command npm run serve. You can see the scheduler with the normal appointments. I want to design a custom editor window with limited fields and add a dropdown list, daytime picker, and text box inside it. I will show you how to design this. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Vue dropdowns and calendars packages in the application. To install dropdowns package, along with their dependencies, use the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2vue-dropdowns, and for calendars package, npm install at syncfusion/ej2vue-calendars. As I have already installed these packages in my application, I am skipping this step here. Second, I will start to customize the editor window. As a first step, I define a template tag with the slot name, Scheduler Editor Template, inside the scheduler code. Then, I map this slot name to the editor template property. Now, let me move on to the template design. I want to place 5 different fields inside the table layout, therefore, I add a table structure with the class names inside the template tag. Here, I am going to define the subject field, so let me set its label as summary and include the input element with a class attribute and set the input type as text. Then, I define the name attribute and assign the subject field to it. Make sure that this name attribute value should exactly match the appropriate mapper field name from the scheduler data source with the same casing. Notice here, this class attribute has eField class and scheduler data source field name subject mapped to the name attribute because, while using the custom editor window, the internal source processing is completely based on these class name eField and name attribute. For all the custom components, we must follow these 2 mandatory steps in the example. Next, I am going to show appointment status in this field, so let me set its label to status. Look at this scheduler data source, I have defined a field event type with 3 status options to display the appointment status. Here, I want to display these 3 status options in this dropdown list component, so I import the dropdown list component from the Syncfusion Vue dropdowns package and declare it in the components property. Then, I define the dropdown list component with the placeholder property to display a short hint. Next, I plan to create a data source for this dropdown list component, so I define a variable named list data source and assigned string values to it. Now, I assign this variable to the data source property of dropdown list component. Next, I need to add a name attribute and map the data source field event type to it. Okay, let me move on to the next fields, which are the start time and end time. First, I define the labels as from and to for start time and end time fields. For these fields, I am going to use the DateTimePicker component to display and select the start and end time values. So, let me import the DateTimePicker component from the Syncfusion Vue Calendars package and declare it in the components property. Then, I define the DateTimePicker component with the class attribute and add the name attribute with the value start time and end time data source fields respectively. Finally, I plan to define a description field, so set its label as reason. I add an input element with a class attribute and set the type as text. Then, I define name attribute and assign the field description to it. And thus, the editor window design is done. Look at the scheduler now. I double-click on the 12 p.m. time slot. Then, you can see the start time and end time fields showing the values, 12 p.m. to 12:30 p.m. in the editor window. Here, I will set the summary text, status, and reason for the appointment now, and simply save it. You can see the appointment getting added over here on the exact chosen time range. If I double-click on the appointment, you can see the appointment values are directly filled in the customized editor window. Look at the editor window title, which is New Event by default, and the Save and Cancel button text. Suppose, I want the editor window text to say, Add Event, and the Save and Cancel button text to be Add and Close, then, I need to pass these custom labels to the locale collection of Scheduler. To do this, first I need to import the L10N class from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package, and then make a call to its load function, within which I can access the locale words of the scheduler. Within this load function, I provide add as the replacement text for the save button, close for the cancel button, and finally, add event for the new event title, which will be shown as the title of the editor window. Now, when I double-click on the cell, the editor window opened with changed text within it. In this video, we have seen how to customize the editor window using a custom template. We have also seen how to add controls to the Vue Scheduler and customize the component text. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. You can also check a link in the description to see if you are eligible for our community license, which lets you use all our essential studio components for free. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thank you for watching.